Hello, good afternoon, everybody. Good morning, depending on where you are and when you're hearing this. My name is Jamie Messina. I'm excited to be on these calls, especially today because we are in for an amazing treat. We have one of the best, not just in our business industry. He's been an individual that's been around for more years if he wants to admit to, but those years of experience have given him the knowledge he's going to share with us today, have given him the ability to be a great leader like he is. And, you know, it's someone like this, Dan Catto, that when you listen to him, you want to make sure you take notes, because every time you listen to him, I've known Dan now for over, every time I hear him speak, there's always something that I pick up that I can use to help me build my business, to help me build my lifestyle. And this is something that is definitely going to benefit everybody on the call here today. So without further ado, I welcome my good friend and my business partner, Dan Catto, to the call. Dan, the call is all yours.
Jamie, thank you. Thank you so much for that kind introduction, my friend. First of all, audio check. How am I coming through?
Loud and clear, buddy.
Great. Great, great, great. Appreciate that, Jamie. Well, first of all, welcome everyone to our webinar, to our call here today. It's 12 noon Eastern Standard Time. I'm reaching you from my home here in Miami on the shores of South Florida. I know I'm reaching today, Jamie, you and I are reaching out, and I know the call is being recorded to, I don't know how many time zones around the world, but again, with the call being recorded and being played back, this virtual around the globe, and we're certainly excited about that. I am very, very excited about today and what I'm going to share with you. This particular training, as you can see, billions and beyond, some of you that have been with me, with us, you know, since the inception of NHT Global, a little over 17 years ago, I did a training similar to this. It was a billion and beyond, and this was before NHT had accomplished a billion in annualized sales or a billion in sales. And we had a vision back then to accomplish that, and we're going to be talking about that as this call unfolds here in our webinar unfolds here just over the next 45 minutes. But we've been able to, well, accomplish so much here in the last 17 years. There's some things that have not changed since we started 17 years ago from a vision standpoint, from a conceptual standpoint, really as far as the basics and the framework of our business and where we wanted to take it. And the vision that we had back 17, 18 years ago, which I'm going to talk to you about today, because where we were back then is so instrumental in where we're going here in the future. And most of what we're going to be talking about today is where we're going to be, and that is beyond. We've accomplished billions in sales. We've eclipsed over 2 billion in sales, but we're going to be talking about the future here today. So some of what you hear today, you've heard in the past, but it's so, so important to never forget where you came from. Never forget where we came from. Never forget what we've accomplished, and never, ever take that for it's been just an incredible journey, an incredible quest that we've been on over the last 17 years, going back to 2001. But, Jamie, we've got, I guess, 45 minutes, just under an hour here. And this is something that, you know, I could talk about over the next several days of what we've accomplished and, again, where we're about to go and what we're about to do, all of that. But, you know, for us to become, and this is really ultimately what we're going to be talking about here today, is a billion-dollar company in annualized sales. Are we in a situation in terms of an opportunity? Are we a business that can embrace a billion-dollar opportunity or a billion-dollar company? First of all, are we in an industry that can support that? And for a lot of people that are not familiar with our industry or just like myself 30 years ago, prior to getting involved in the industry, it was a misunderstood industry a little over 30 years ago. And prior to that, I did not understand it at all. I had all the preconceived misconceptions on this industry. But gang, what has happened here over the last 30 years and as an industry over the last 100 years has been nothing short of staggering. Just to give you an idea of what's happening within this industry of direct sales, direct marketing, network marketing, multi-level marketing, all under the umbrella of what we can call in the street language of direct sales. How big is this industry? Well, we're closing in on becoming a quarter of a trillion dollar industry. If you take a look at that are being paid out in this, there's not many other industries in the world today that can rival it. The top income earners in our industry today are earning over $1 million a week in terms of commissions and income. That's not just business volume or revenue. These are commissions that are being paid out the top income earners today. You know, Paul Zane Pilsner years ago wrote a book called The Next Trillion. Paul Zane Pilsner, if you're not familiar who he was the former chief economist on the first and second Bush administration, presidential administration, the top economist in the world. He's written a number of great, great books, one of them being Unlimited Wealth, which we're going to share. I'm going to discuss some of the preface in that book and how that relates to us and where we are today. But one of the good reads and books that he had written over the years was The Next Trillion, when he talked about our industry in terms of health and wellness and direct sales and direct marketing becoming the next trillion-dollar industry. You know, you go back years ago and years ago, back in the 50s and the 60s, franchising was very close to illegal in North America. It was like one or two votes away from the House of Senate being deemed illegal. But today, such a traditional method of distribution and just a model of business that we have around the world today. But, you know, it was our industry of direct sales and direct marketing, again, being misunderstood for such a long time. But today, pretty much fashionable. Just about everybody that you know today is either purchasing a product, buying a product, or involved in our industry somewhere in North America, and it's growing around the globe today. When you take a look at franchising back in the 50s and 60s and where it is today, our industry is growing faster than franchising. That's today. And they predict within the next 5 to 10 years, the industry of direct sales and direct marketing will eclipse franchising. Really, gang, what we've got here in from a conceptual form years is virtual franchising. Being able to take franchising that we have around the world and be able to package it for the masses and making it available globally. So we're going to be talking about global, every aspect of our opportunity and who we are as a company, but where we are as an industry. Do we have a billion-dollar industry? No question. We're closing in on a quarter of a trillion-dollar industry. It's very interesting. You know, Wall Street Journal, I remember years ago, I read this article, and it said, you know, don't marry for money. Go where the money is, then fall in love. Well, there's certainly the opportunity here. There's certainly the industry to support a billion-dollar company or a billion-dollar opportunity, and that has been proven out. So we're certainly in an industry that can support it. Do we have a company? Now, for most of you, you understand the numbers that are happening out there. For a lot of you that are new, you can Google all of this and you can get the information on NHT and what's been happening with NHT Global here in the last 17 years. It's nothing short of staggering what we've been able to accomplish in 17 plus years. It's a record-setting company. One, we're publicly traded, so virtually everything that we have here is transparent. A lot of privately held companies that are out there just don't know everything that's happening with them because they're private, and to some degree that's protected, and it's not fully transparent. You will know everything about NHT Global because we're publicly traded. Take a look at the index that we're trading, which is the NASDAQ. Trading on the New York Stock Exchange, one of the most scrutinized exchanges in the world today. Being scrutinized like that as an exchange and us having to be a part of all of the regulatory laws and policies that you have, being a part of that stock exchange, the NASDAQ in New York, you have to abide to all of that, cross every T, dot every I, and it's transparent on all aspects, from our compensation plan to our products to our policies and procedures. We're under such a high, we have to be the very best at what we're doing. So a record-setting company, I mean, take a look at Fortune 100. This has never been done before in this industry and outside of our industry, where Fortune 100 has ranked us 3 years in a row in the top two, and then number one 2 years in a row, publicly traded, fastest growing company in any industry. That is virtually unheard of. Jefferies, just a couple of years ago, this is one of the stock investment houses that you have in New York, rated our investment from a stock standpoint as one of the top stock investments that you could make in the world today. And that was just a couple of years ago. You take a look at our e-commerce business model. Our e-commerce business model is being taught at the finest business schools that we have in the Far East and Asia, the University of Shanghai, Guangzhou, and Beijing. And just incredible testimonial and credibility to what we've been able to do as a company and where we are today. But so much of this started to shift and change a number of years ago when our new CEO at the time that we had got from Mattel, and for us to become a $1 billion company in terms of annualized sales, we needed someone who had done it before. Chris Sharn, who's the head of NHT Global, we were able to bring from Mattel, and Mattel, one of the largest companies in the world, ran the largest $1 billion division from Mattel, came over here to NHT Global as our CFO and eventually took over the helm of the ship to help us from a visionary standpoint and drive our business corporately and operationally in-house with NHT Global. Chris Sharn is certainly the finest CEO that we have in the industry today. So from a company standpoint and what we've been able to do, from a CEO standpoint, we've been the best, we are the best, but we're planning to do so much more, as I'm going to share with you as we go on from here. But one, we've also got to have a vision, a $1 billion vision. And, you know, when Joe Garcia and I, my partner and I, back a little over 17 years ago, got started in Toronto, Canada, just with one product. We had one website, a black and white website, no color, black and white brochures, no color. We didn't really have, we didn't have any reference. We didn't have the testimonials of and a frame of reference, certainly like what we've got today. But we had a vision that one day we would be able to take not just the one product that we had at that time, but multiple products, and to be in multiple markets around the world and accomplish $1 billion in sales. We certainly have done that. So you have to start with that $1 billion vision. But our vision today is to become a $1 billion company in annualized sales. We're about to do that. Now, to go on from there, the next slide that just I want to share with you is our business model. You know, for a lot of people that have looked at NHT, and they've seen what we've been able to do over the last 17 years, so much of what they look at, when they take a look at our success, is they say it must be the products. We're going to talk about that in the coming slides here, just as we go. And also the compensation plan. They say you must have the finest compensation plan, and that has got to be the reason why you've had the success that you've had. Well, the product plan have been a huge part of our success, but they're not the single biggest reason for our success. It's been a part of the package of our model and what we've done. And the single biggest reason why we've been able to do all of this is our business model. And I'll give you an example. It just on the street in other companies that have preceded us and what they've been able to do with the proper packaging of their products, their compensation plan, their incentives, and their promotions of what they've done. And that has been all wrapped with their business model. To give an example, with McDonald's. McDonald's, arguably the greatest franchise in history. Did they have the best products? Absolutely not. Did they overpay their employees? Take a look at Walmart. Did they have superior products? Did they overpay their employees? No. What they had was an incredible business model, and the products and how they paid their people fit their demographic. Their marketing business model that they had for the demographic of the consumer, the customer that they wanted to take that business to, they were able to do it with the right business model. Our business model that we have today has taken bricks and clicks. You know, we've gone from bricks to clicks. Take a look at what's happened today because of technology in the last 20 years. Remember, when we got years ago, really about 10% of the people, and I remember that very first business presentation that I did back in Toronto, Canada, back in 2001 with Joe Garcia, we had 100 people in the room that day, and less than 10 of people in the room that day, and these were pretty savvy business guys and ladies, less than 10 out of that 100 had a computer in their home. That's how far we've come in the last 17, 18 years, really as a society, but where technology has gone just in the last 20 years. It's been incredible. So you see the success of McDonald's. You see the success of Walmart. But look what's happened. Google, Facebook, Amazon, Alibaba. What have we done? We as a business model and a marketing model have been able to take our product, take our opportunity, combined with technology and that model and our e-commerce business model that is being taught at the finest business schools in the Far East and being predicted to be the next Dell, the next Coca-Cola, branding us as that for the future. We've been able to combine the opportunity along with the products and have become a distribution machine around the world. So our business model is not local, it's global. Everything that we have, and we're going to move to the next slide here, everything that we're doing is global. Everything that we talk about, all of our vision that we have, is not about North America. Everything that we're thinking about doing is not just about Europe. It's not just about South America. It is about Africa. It is about all of the Far East. It is about, yes, all of South America, where we plan on being here just in the next 2 to 3, no more than 5 years. All of this. So everything has to fit into our global business model. The products need to fit that demographic. Very similar to Walmart, how their products fit into that demographic. How McDonald's, their products that you'll get at any McDonald's that you go to, how does that fit into the demographic? Well, let's take a look at our products and how that fits into our billion-dollar global demographic. The first product that we introduced back in 2001, we'll go to the next slide here, and this pie chart that you're going to see and how we started off, you're on the webinar here, if you've called in, you're going to have to come back on the replay, and you can see some of the slides that we've got here, but I've got seven pieces of pie on our pie chart here in terms of our product demographic and how this all fits into the global appeal. So it doesn't matter if you're someone in China, if you're someone in Russia, if you're in South America, anywhere in the world, these products will fit that market. You'll be able to sell them. You'll be able to consume them. People are going to reorder them, and you're going to get paid on it. How did this all happen? Well, it started, first of all, with this vision becoming, obviously, just what I've shared with you here, this billion-dollar vision, but it starts with that first step, that first product. The very first product that we introduced was Allura. It was under another name back in 2001, but ultimately became the name Allura, which, in layman's terms, is the female version of Viagra. That was our very first product, which was our flagship product. The second product we introduced, Skindulgence, 30-minute non-surgical instant facelift. Both of those products are topical products. Both of those products, when we introduced them, no one had. We knew everyone was going to have, and everyone, the masses, could afford. Now, what was cool about this, being a flagship product, what that meant is that we could take these products around the world quickly. Why? Because they were topical. They weren't products that were being ingested. These were two products that fed and fit the masses. They were demonstratable. They were retailable. We're going to get into this in a second. Consumable. And they were impacting people's lives. We're going to talk a little bit more about this and how this all fits into this model. Now, here's the unfair advantage that we have with the competition. You go to our competition today, for the most part, they will be leading as they go into other markets with ingestible type products. That is their flagship product. Very difficult to get into other markets, new markets around the world with ingestibles. Products that you're consuming, you're swallowing, that are going into your body. Why? Because the approval process and process that you've got with that takes forever. There's some markets that, you know, companies are still not in. Australia is one of the toughest ones. Canada is another tough one. I'm not going to mention any more, but there's a multiple markets around the world where it's very, very difficult to be able to get your products into that marketplace. But when you have a topical product, the approval process, because it's a topical, the approval process in most cases is less than a month. So what happens when you introduce that product? You're into that market for 90 days, 6 months, up to a year. Then you introduce your second product, which we did, which was the Skindulgence product, non-surgical instant facelift. You establish that relationship with that local governing body in that particular market. Once you've done that, you've established a great relationship with them, then you bring in the other products, which is the fleet. So you start with a flagship, then you bring in the fleet, and what is the fleet of products? Those are the consumables. Those are the consumables that are at the very core of our repeat reorder business. One-time sale, lifetime income. Those flagship products have to be demonstratable. So the average person, the person who has never sold a thing in their life, a person who is not highly skilled in talking in the front of the room or just even with a couple of people, but all they need to do is just demonstrate the product and be able to demonstrate it in less than 60 seconds. Our products will do that. You can do that literally, as I said, literally within minutes. They are also retailable. Retailable, so you've got a retail commission when you can go out and sell the product. So there's immediate commissions. Easy to demonstrate, simple to demonstrate. Remember that word, simplicity, that is critical. Retailable, so you've got the retail commissions. And they're consumable, so you've got that repeat reorder business. Now, we've just jumped up to consumable in the pie chart here, but take a look at the masses out there. Most of the other companies that were in this competitive marketplace that are out there, yes, they understand and recognize consumption and consumables. But do they have impact consumables? For the most part, most of the products that you'll see in our industry, and even outside of our industry, unless you're a real cutting-edge company, which we're going to be talking about here as we go along in the webinar, is most of them have just a consumable-type product that is not an impact consumable. What I mean by that is that when one of our customers or distributors is using our products, it will impact their lives when they're using the products in a positive way. The relationships now, because of the Allura, have never been better. They've never felt better. They've never looked better. They've lost weight. They've impacted their lives. That product, because they took that product, it has impacted their lives from a positive standpoint. When they don't take that product, it impacts their life from a negative standpoint. And most of the competition, when you have a consumable, if they don't have that product, it's not available to that particular company, they can go over to XYZ company and get a very similar product and get the same results, et cetera, et cetera. No, for the most part, with a consumption base and the impact products that we've got, they're exclusive to NHT Global just on its own. So the only place that you can get them is with NHT Global. And that has been the way for the last 17 years, all a part of our global appeal and our approach to taking our products to the marketplace. Lastly, new products. If you take a look at most of the companies that have ever gotten to the $1 billion in annualized sales threshold, they were in a position to introduce new products. How powerful is that? Well, I'll give you a couple of analogies here and what has happened in the marketplace outside of our industry, and I'll talk to you about what's happened within our industry and using that as a frame of reference and as a model. Years ago, I've used this example, but it was powerful. The first time I heard it and saw it was McDonald's. McDonald's, as a franchise, started to introduce new products. Remember what they started with years and years and years ago. You know, it was hamburgers, French fries, milkshakes, and Coke. They really only had four products. As they started to introduce more products in terms of their menu, what happened to their business? The month that they introduced McChicken and McPizza, within 30 days, they became the largest distributor of chicken and pizza in North America, outselling all of the competition combined. And they weren't in the chicken business, and they weren't in the pizza business. They were in the distribution business, which I'm going to be talking about here a little bit more as we go along. But all they did was introduce new products to their distributor base and what happened to their revenue and their business. But for us to grow as a company, as an opportunity, and you as a business, you need to be in a position where you're introducing new products. It's critical to our success. What's really cool is you build your business over a number of years, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 10 years. What happens? Well, I'll give you an example. Years ago, before I got involved in this industry, it might have been 35 years ago, I was having a conversation with a gentleman that was with Amway at the time. He was one of their top diamonds. I just happened to be in a social situation. I knew nothing about the industry. I knew nothing about their company, other than I had preconceived misconceptions on it. We're having a very open conversation, and I asked him how he was doing, and he was earning a seven-figure income. That was 35 years ago. That's a lot of money. But he was very excited about this new product they introduced, and he was telling me about them introducing toilet paper to their distributor base, to their consumer base. And he said, you know, my income went up over $10,000 a month just when they introduced toilet paper. Amway has got well over 8,000 products in their distribution mix. So once you've established that distributor base, we're going to talk about this as we go forward here as an opportunity and what happens with your business. As new products are introduced, what happens to your business? What happens to you? Let's use this. You've got two fish bowls. You got one fish bowl that has got 10 fish in it. You got another fish bowl that has got 10,000 fish in it, and you're getting paid on the fish food. Which fish bowl do you want? Obviously, the one with 10,000 fish. We're going to talk about that just in the next couple of slides here and how powerful that is. But being in a position where you're introducing new products that are cutting edge, that no one has, everyone will have, and the masses, what is going to happen to you and your business? This is what we've got. It has to have global appeal. The products that we introduce, for the most part, across the board, people will be loving, wanting, and using and consuming in every country, market, town, village, home around the world. They need to have global appeal. So let's take a look at the next part of our process here in the compensation plan, and it's to have this global reach. Some of these slides, gang, I'm going to go, I'm just going to fast forward here. I want to get all of this in within 60 minutes if we can here, and we've got 28, 29 minutes to go here. But the compensation plan and how powerful that is, and what type of comp plan do you need if you want to have a global opportunity or you've got this global vision? You need to have certainty to have this global reach. You need to have a global, seamless compensation plan. Here's the key. This is the key. For you as distributors, you've been involved in our industry for some time. You understand our industry, there's four fundamental compensation plans. They're called unilevel, matrix, breakaway, and the last one being a binary compensation plan. Ours in format is basically, when I say basically, it's a binary compensation plan. What that means is that it's seamless, and it's seamless around the world. When I say basically, we have a unilevel and generational component to our compensation plan to help the brand new people when they're first getting started. But if you one day in 5 years, 6 years, 7 years, or maybe even in a year, but what we're finding even in a matter of months, having business outside of your own area code, certainly your own town, but across the country and into other countries and markets around the world, you need to have a seamless global. The other compensation plans, for the most part, some of the archaic ones that we have in our industry, for some of those companies that have been around for, God bless them, they have pioneered our industry 50 and 60 and 70 years, have compensation plans that are based on levels and generations. Generations means it's static. That means it stops. That means that once you got to the seventh level, you stop getting paid. Once you get to the sixth or seventh or eighth generation, you stop getting paid. Here with NHT Global, you have a seamless global compensation plan that is based on volume. No matter where you are in the world, no matter who you introduced it to, that introduced it to, that introduced it to, that introduced it to, infinitely, if that's a word, around the world. It can go, if it was levels, 30, 40, 50, 60, 100, 1,000, 30,000, it doesn't matter because it's based on volume. So you're protected through that, and it has a global reach. So where the gang, think about how powerful this is. You know, this allows us to reach 7 billion people. The landscape has changed. This is not a local business anymore. This is not a local opportunity. This is not a local industry. It's a global industry. You need to have products that have global reach and global appeal. You need a compensation plan that has global reach and global appeal and be able to touch every country, market, person around the world, and you get paid for this. This is the plan that we had envisioned 17 years ago. This is why we've been able to do over $2 billion in sales and screaming. So there's so much more to do. This compensation plan, very similar to the global appeal that we have with our products, fits into our demographic in terms of our business model. Very similar to what Walmart did years and years ago. Very similar to what McDonald's had set out in doing years and years and years ago. But what a lot of the other situations, companies, and opportunities that you have that are out there inside and outside of our industry, but outside of our industry, like the Alibabas, you know, like Amazon, like Google, you take a look at what they've been able to do in terms of their global reach at Amazon and Alibaba. We have been able to do that through virtual franchising, which is what I shared with you on the front end, is what we have ultimately become in terms of an opportunity. So that was the compensation plan. Gang, what else do you need to do? We'll go to the next slide here. We need to be cutting edge in terms of technology. When we got started back in 2001, we were one of the very first in our industry to have a back office. You know all of the orders that we're placing today are all basically, well, it's all done online. Certainly there's the retail commissions and the retail sales. But we have to, in terms of our future and where we go, have to be cutting edge in terms of technology. You know, the Wall Street Journal had a very interesting piece about 3 weeks ago where they were talking about the CIO, the Chief Information Officer of a company, is becoming as important, if not more important, than the CEO of the company. Basically, the message is this. Our future is technology. So much of our future is technology in terms of delivery, support, our systems. You know, Paul Zane Pilsner wrote this book, Unlimited Wealth, back in 1989. I got involved in the industry in 1988. In his book, Paul Zane Pilsner, one of the top economists in the world that wrote that book, The Next Trillion. This book, Unlimited Wealth, in 1989, think about this. He said that wealth was going to be created in the next decade. And that was the 90s, but certainly the 21st century in three areas: technology, communication, and distribution. Technology, communication, and distribution. That is really at the core of our operational system and model in getting our opportunity and getting our products out to the marketplace. We have to, again, be cutting edge in terms of our technology. We certainly are as a company, and we understand that in us going forward, that we need to be on top, current, and cutting edge, not just in the products and our incentives and our promotions, what we have out there, but in terms of our technology and supporting our people. The next slide I want to share with you is our system. Our system needs to be global. So when you bring somebody into the business, and you don't know these people, but because of our model, remember, they're all being supported through that, but this is part of our vision and where we go and taking the opportunity, is that there's a system to support it. So it doesn't matter if you've got 5 people or 50 people or 500, but certainly when you get into the thousands of people on your team, your organization, customers and distributors, be a system to support that and drive that around the world. Our events, our tools, our recognition program, which is our IRP, International, are really the pillars of our system to support it. But it doesn't matter where you are today in your business. It doesn't bring in, no matter where they are in the world. And gang, going to be in Africa. We will be in every single country in that continent. Remember, there's 1.3, nearly 4 billion people in Africa. The fastest growing market that we have in the world today in our industry is Africa. You know, you've got a level playing field. South America, we'll be at all of South America here just in the, you know, next 24 to 36 months, no more than 48 months, every single country in South America. But for the first time in history, we have a level playing field for every person in the world. It doesn't matter if you're coming from a village where there's no running water, there's no electricity. Why does it not? Because our people today, we've got distributors today in Peru coming from those little towns, those little villages, and from homes where there is no running water, there is no electricity, but they're able to find a way and, you know, achieve the highest ranks that we have in our international recognition program. Our top distributors that we have that are in the Far East, in Asia, and in China, and they're coming in from villages and towns and homes where they don't have, again, the running water and electricity. But they're hitting the highest levels that we've got in our international recognition program, Global Ambassador. How is that all happening? Well, one, we have the model to do that. We have a system to support it. We certainly have the products, but that compensation plan that reaches it. But it doesn't happen without a system. The next slide I want to share with you, which is critical, and we've talked a little bit about it, is the new markets. Being able to grow. If you take a look at all companies outside within our industry as well, they can't grow unless they're introducing new products or new markets. And one day we will be in every home, in every town, in every village, in every province, state, country, market around the world. We're opening up new countries and new markets basically every quarter. We just got off a huge conference call in the last 48 hours talking a lot about South America. We just started shipping more and more product from a distributor standpoint just this past week. We're, I think, about 15 gold packages were going into India as well. There's another market, India, the largest democracy, the fastest growing middle class in the world. Gang, this is a marketplace that, again, is not local, regional, or national. It is global. This is a marketplace that we're going to be able to take these products and this opportunity to 7 billion people. On the next slide, and when we're talking about what we do in supporting our teams and our organizations, you need to have incentives and promotions that will support that. You know, a survey was done of people in North America and in Europe, and they surveyed the families, the mom, the dad, the kids. What were the dream kind of components and things that they had within the family that they wanted as a family? And here they were. They talked about having a dream home. They talked about having this dream vacation for the family. Dream home, a dream vacation. They ultimately wanted to have this financial freedom so they could spend more time together, you know, on these vacations. They wanted to be able to spend just more time even at home. They wanted to be able to have that dream car. They wanted to be able to have that dream education, being able to get to, you know, the finest schools and universities in the world. Was that an opportunity? But to basically have that freedom to be able to do what you want, with whom you want, wherever you want, and you were not owned. You owned it. It didn't own you. Being able to be a part of maybe a publicly traded company and having stock or being an investor and a part owner in one of the top companies around the world. This was all part of the dream freedom and the dreams that families, parents, and the kids, when they were surveyed, being together in a dream home, that dream vacation, in that dream car, being able to go to the finest university and schools around the world, and having the freedom to do it whenever you wanted. This is what we provide with our incentives and promotions. We have a supreme bonus. If you're hearing this for the first time, you want to get as much information you can on our supreme bonus program that provides these types of incentives and promotions that I've just shared with you around the world in all of our countries and markets that we're going into, and that we're obviously the countries that we're in today as we speak today. But in the next slide, you know, Peter Drucker is one of my heroes. He said the key, and he is one of the great business visionaries in history. He said one of the real keys to your business and success in your business is marketing and innovation. We've talked to you about how important the products are, how important the compensation is. It really does fit that demographic, but you really need to be in a position from a marketing standpoint and an innovation standpoint to be able to change in what's happening out there. Charles Darwin said the true genius in life was the ability to adapt and adjust to change. The one constant that you're going to have in life is change. At our very, very core, this won't change. Incredible products. That will never change. Number two, all people, no matter where you go around the world, they all want a better way of life. That is at the very core of our success, is delivering incredible products that will impact people's lives, that will change people's lives, enhance people's lives. I'm not going to say the last one, but it's helped save my life because I've had to deal with a massive health challenge, ulcerative colitis and Crohn's disease, and the products have been really more than beneficial in helping me from that standpoint. But we as an opportunity and as a company have to be poised and in a position to maximize our marketing and be in a position to innovate. Let's take a look at the next slide here. Who drives this thing? We've talked about the corporate leadership from Chris Sharn to now the field leadership. This next slide is a shot of Joe and I, my partner and I. We met over 25 years ago when Joe was a part of my organization with another company that we were both involved with. And we eventually combined ourselves from a partnership standpoint and putting a distributorship together, which all of you are a part of. And Garth Wright is a huge part of. Between the three of us, Garth is on this call today. He's tying in from the Czech Republic. Garth is a dear, dear friend and business partner as well. But between the three of us, and for just about all of you that are on this call, on this webinar today, you're a part of our organizations around the world. We're here to serve. We're here to serve you, to help you, guide you, direct you in any which way possible. But we've got over 100 years combined experience in this industry. Yeah, between the three of us. Thank God for these products. Between the three of us, again, over 100 years of full-time experience. So we've done this before. This is not our first rodeo. We've been doing this for some time. For myself, I'll be coming up in 30 years this June. All three of us have had a corporate background prior to getting involved in this industry. We've owned our own business prior to getting involved in this industry. And we've also, as I shared with you, between the three of us, spent over 100 years of combined experience in this industry. So we understand Main Street. We understand the other side of the street, traditional business. But boy, do we get this industry. So wherever we're coming from in terms of our guidance, our direction, our leadership, it's coming from experience. We've done this before. You know, we've shared your pain. We've shared your joy. We've shared your blood, sweat, and tears, your ups, your downs. All of the experiences that you could ever imagine that you have gone through or you will go through. Joe, myself, and Garth Wright, we've gone through it. So we're here to help you, support you, direct you, guide you in any which way possible. We do not win until you do. So our mission and our vision for us to get to $1 billion in terms of annualized sales is to do whatever we can in helping you get to where you want to be in terms of this opportunity. And from a distributor standpoint, it's on the IRP, our International Recognition Program, to get you to that next rank and ultimately to become a global ambassador. And for all of you, as you know, and if you don't, check this out, but to become a global ambassador today with NHT Global, just to qualify on your cycling bonus, you're earning pretty much $1 million a year. Some of our global ambassadors are earning much, much, much more than that. But it is a fact, just about 90% of our ambassadors got there in less than 5 years. Most of those global ambassadors are coming from the emerging markets. Most of those ambassadors have never been involved in our industry before. That's our industry of network marketing, direct sales, and direct marketing. Most of those are women, and a lot of them had never held a job before. That's an incredible testimonial to this opportunity. We have done this much. We have done over $2 billion in sales in the last nearly 18 years, and it takes us to the last slide. Excuse me, and this chokes me up, is the potential and the opportunity. Excuse me. Pardon me. Just going to take a shot of Noni here. But it takes us to the potential and the opportunity. We have done all of what I've just shared with you. And so many of you know this, but for you that are new, or you just maybe did not and you weren't aware of the sales that we've done, the countries that we're in, the products that we've introduced, the results that we've been able to produce around the world in these emerging markets, in the Far East, what we've been able to do now down in South America, what we're about to do in Africa, India, still in Europe and Eastern Europe and all of these markets around the world. And there's so much more to do. And we've done what we've done over the last 18 years. Still 99%, 99.9% of the people in Texas, where our first warehouse and office was founded, Toronto, Canada, where their very first opportunity meeting was ever held by Dan Catto and Joe Garcia, Las Vegas, where our very first event was ever held in May of 2001, 99%+ of the people in those cities, in those markets, have never heard of our products and have never, ever heard of NHT Global. That's unbelievable. Unbelievable. They've never heard of us, but they're going to. And when they do, whose team are they going to be on? Yours. So everything that we've been able to accomplish here in the last 18 years obviously pales in comparison to what we're going to do in the next 18 years. We've done a couple of billion in sales, but our goal is to do a billion in annualized sales. And, you know, in talking to my man Garcia, the same thing with Garth, and we've had these conversations with Chris Sharn, we as a company ultimately want to be doing $1 billion a month in sales. When we get to $1 billion a year in sales and $1 billion down the road in monthly sales, where's your business going to be? What kind of an opportunity we have today? It's up to you to seize that opportunity with all of this incredible potential that we have in front of us. So gang, I just want to thank all of you for tying into our webinar and our call today. I know we're reaching, I don't know how many time zones. We've got, I know Asia tied into this webinar today. They're 12 hours ahead. So one in the morning for a lot of our friends over there in Asia. In Europe, you're 6 hours ahead. In down in South America and Peru and, well, parts of North America, we've got 3 or 4 hours. In parts of Canada, 5 hour time zones. And if you're in Russia, it's 11 time zones. Absolutely incredible. But I want to thank all of you for tying into this webinar today. You know, a happy Passover and a happy Easter and a happy, happy weekend to all of our friends around the world here in this particular weekend. But boy, have we got an opportunity. Boy, do we have potential here. And I believe we've got the greatest distributors in our industry today. Let's take advantage of it. So, gang, thank you so much for tying into our call and our webinar again today. And just have a great, great weekend and family weekend. And we'll talk to you real soon. Take care, everybody. Bye-bye.